2% applicants for any job get an interview call. And yet, I don't remember applying for any job where I didn't get at least an interview call. So how do I consistently keep getting the attention of all these recruiters? That's what we're talking about today. What's up, friends? Sadia Khaf here. Welcome back to the channel. I'm a machine learning engineer who just got an internship at Ericsson. On this channel, I talk a lot about the scholarships that I get and I tell you how to get those scholarships too, but I've never really talked about my employment history. Let's fix that. The first job I ever applied for was at a company called Ibrahim Fibers. I got it. The second and third jobs I ever applied for were two lecturer positions at two of the best engineering universities in Pakistan. Unfortunately, I had to cancel my second interview because I went for the first interview for the first position I applied for and I got it. And I really liked the university. I always wanted to teach there, so I had to cancel the second interview call that I got. And that brings me to my third paid job, which is this internship offer from Ericsson. I applied for this internship and I got it. This is the first and only internship I've ever applied for during my PhD. And today I'm going to share with you my secret sauce for getting an interview call from every single position that you apply for. The secret sauce? Stop applying with one CV for every single position. It's as simple as that. No matter what everybody tells you. There are really just three things to everything. Number one, stop applying for 100 positions. Your chances do not increase with the number of positions you apply for. It's not a linear relationship. Stop applying for 100 positions that are not even relevant to you. Number two, stop applying with one generic CV to all these positions. Stop sending like one shoe fits all kind of CV that you just copy paste everywhere, one cover letter, one email template that you just send to all the recruiters. Nobody's going to bother reading that. Even when I was hiring editors to edit my video, I was simply discarding all the applicants that just sent me a standard copy-paste proposal for editing my videos. So stop using one shoe fits all. One shoe does not fit all positions. And step number three, which is exactly this, the emphasis is don't send application without fitting it to the specific job position. Don't even think about it. Don't send your CV without editing it for that particular internship or that particular job. No matter how good your CV is, no matter what a fantastic researcher you are, no matter what an amazing CV you have built over the years, don't send it without editing it every single time before applying for any internship, any job, because every job is different, every internship is different, and you need to make modifications in your CV to highlight it that you're the best candidate for that particular job. So don't even think about sending your CV without making it extremely relevant to the job. CV versus resume, that's another important question. Which one to send? In general, send the one that they explicitly ask. If they ask for CV, send the CV. If they ask for resume, send the resume. But if they don't specify, my recommendation would be to send the resume. It's short, it's concise, it's to the point, and it's relevant to the job. So if they haven't specified which one they want, just send the resume. The most important tip I can give is asking for feedback. The CV that I just showed you for Ericsson, even though I have reviewed so many CVs for other people, when I'm writing my own CV, I still asked for review from my friends. Because, you know, the other set of eyes always spot something that you might not be spotting in your own CV because you're writing it, you're in a certain state of mind, you might not spot some errors, some mistakes that you're making, even if you're expert at CV writing. There will be something that an other person's perspective can always offer. So always, always, always ask feedback from your friends, send your CV to your friends, ask them how you can improve it before sending it for one particular internship or a job. So let's take a look at my CV that got me this internship at Ericsson. Obviously, that's not my real phone number and email, but this is my tagline. I'm a PhD candidate in electrical engineer with focus on machine learning for wireless communications. First up, I list my education. Don't look at my CGPA, buddy. There are two things you never ask a woman, her age and her CGPA. Anyways, I think it's too late. I list my education. I show exactly what projects I worked on during my PhD, during my master's and my bachelor's. After that, I list my experience. experiences, and I break it down into academic and industrial experience. Academically, I worked 3 jobs. One of them was internship, and the other one was also as a graduate assistant at university, but it looks good on the CV, so I put it there. This is what I did in each of these research experiences. This was my industrial job. After listing my jobs, I list some of the projects, and this section is very, very important. This is something I wrote specifically for this internship at Ericsson. I only listed the projects that were very relevant for this particular internship that I was applying for. So I only listed the machine learning related projects and the communications and IoT related projects, because this internship is about machine learning for wireless communications. So this is very, very relevant to this job. Same goes for the software skills. I listed only the relevant skills for this internship, and all the skills that were mildly relevant or not relevant at all, I just took them away. So for this particular internship, I included IoT Homebridge, Hooves. These are the skills that I never usually list for any other CVs. Same goes for all these Python skills, the specifics of what libraries I've worked on. So I specifically listed them for this particular internship. After that, in the awards and honors section, this is the section that usually goes long and long and long in all of my CVs, because I ended up getting quite a lot during my studies, but I had to short it down here. I only listed the most relevant ones, the scholarships that I recently got, or some research scholarships that are relevant or that show that I have good potential for research, I guess. So I only listed short list of the awards and honors. I took down the rest to make my CV a bit short. For the publications, I used a Google Scholar link for the complete list of publications, so that if they are interested, they can go through my publications on Google Scholar. And to save space, I only listed 2 of my most recent papers in this particular CV. Kept it to 2 pages. And even if they ask you for a complete long CV, nobody really bothers reading it. Try to keep it as concise as possible, as short as possible. If you did a job as a babysitter somewhere, that's not relevant. Don't mention it on your CV when you're applying for a research internship. Keep it relevant, keep it simple, keep it short. If this video helped you, don't forget to share with others, don't forget to subscribe, and don't forget to see other helpful tips on my channel. If you're still unsure how to make a CV, and if you want to know how to demonstrate your research potential in your CV without having tons and tons of publications, I have another video. I will link it to the description, or I will link it to the end of this video. Don't forget to watch it for highlighting your research potential in your CV without having any publications at all. See you next time.